Asha workers, as you all know, that they are doing the community health work, where they have, and particularly during this pandemic, they were put on duty for COVID-related duties, particularly among the people. So they were to check for the patients and who are returning, the returned migrants, all those kinds of work which they were directly exposed to the COVID patients and this pandemic. So there the government was not at all providing. This is a central government scheme being implemented by the state government. Neither the central government nor the state government was not providing them with any basic safety equipments, even the sanitizer and the mask. So this was the first thing which we raised, that we are not saying no to any kind of work which is very important for the country and its people. And they, but the safety of the workers, in two aspects, because we ourselves will get infected and it is a threat to our own lives, but at the same time we will be infecting people. So it will be spreading of COVID also through the community health workers. In both these aspects, it is very important to provide the safety equipments, but that was not given. And for 4 months continuously the workers were working, and the central government announced only 1,000 rupees per month as an additional risk allowance, or whatever you may call. And as you can also see that in a survey was conducted, 70% of the ASHA workers did not even get that increased remuneration which they were supposed to get. And in addition to that, when they were doing a fantastic job, very appreciated by everybody, and without them, that even the statistics know this work was reaching the people. And they were risking their lives. Many got infected, and all over the country, many have died also during this pandemic due to corona infection. And many died and they were not even checked for the corona, that because it was very difficult to prove that they are died of corona. So in that context, that was the basic demand which we started, but we never had any kind of a struggle or anything. We were just demanding this. And in the second phase, you see, after these 4 months, these deaths and all started, and the government announced an insurance scheme package for 50 lakh those who died. But our point was that if one person is infected and their entire health, even they were not continuously or randomly checked for corona infection being there, and even their expenses of this treatment and all, and a remuneration for those period also, a risk allowance in addition to the risk allowance, they have to be provided. But that was never, means nobody even discussed about all these things. And this insurance, which is 50 lakhs after death, that was not given to many of the people because there was nothing to prove that they were doing the COVID duty, and even they were getting infected, they were not checked. So this was also, means in only a few, less than 10 people must have throughout the country got this after death also, their insurance has been provided. The Anganwadi workers are also put on duty for the COVID-related assignments, and even in the quarantine centers, they were to take the patients to the hospital like ASHA workers in most of the states. A few states, they were not put on the COVID duty. But they were having this, they are supposed to provide the supplementary nutrition under six children and the pregnant women and the lactating. So there, the cooked food is totally stopped because the Anganwadi centers are closed. But the Anganwadi workers and helpers are asked to provide dry ration to the beneficiaries to take this their homes. So they also didn't say no to any of this kind of work because it is a very important question, particularly when this unemployment and the poverty hunger is prevalent there. So they were taking this ration, but first of all, we demanded that it is hot cooked food providing. If you are putting it as a dry ration, it is a very less quantity, and it is not sufficient if you are providing it at home, because it will not ensure that the child or the mother will get enough quantity of and also the quality. So you have to increase the items and you have to increase the quantity of the ration. So the government did not even increase 1 rupee for the entire supplementary nutrition during this COVID period, in spite of the UNICEF warning that 3 lakh more children will die in the next 6 months because of malnutrition. So there, one is that they were also on the COVID duty, they were at risk. And also this nutrition question also, they were not provided with any transportation, even up to for the entire children. They were carrying this load of dry ration on their heads and reaching it to the beneficiaries. So there was nothing given to them also. So the similar kind of demands we took, that the risk allowance and additional remuneration, and also the safety equipments. These were the demands. But it was not given, and in different, they had big struggles. In Maharashtra, they had a struggle, also the ASHA workers. So they were given some kind of additional state-wise remuneration. But in national level, the Anganwadi workers were not included even in the category of the workers who will be getting the insurance coverage. That also was not done. And these were the demands during this lockdown which we were taking. You see that the Anganwadi workers and the ASHA workers. ASHA workers are piece rate workers. So each and every service for it around, means if it is a 6 months of means 9 months of maternity care of the pregnant woman, and they have to take care of them, and if the delivery is an institutional delivery, they will be getting for the care around 250 rupees, and for the surgery around 250 or so rupees. So there, one more thing is that if you are taking care of the entire 9 months, and if the woman is going to her own house for delivery, then the ASHA worker will not get any money because she will be going in another place for delivery. So this is the kind of thing, and everything, if it is for immunization or any other kind of service, even distribution of condoms or that kind of work, it is all piece rated work. And then we had a long agitation, and the central government announced first 1,000 rupees minimum per month. And then in 2018, we had a big struggle, and it was increased to 2,000 rupees per month as a minimum. This is all over India. In many states, we had big struggles, and they got an additional remuneration. And the Anganwadi workers also, they were, the ICDS scheme started in 1975. From there, in up to 2018, they were getting 3,000 rupees per month for the worker and 1,500 for the helper. In 2018, along with the ASHAs, we had a big struggle, and in the 5th September, it was a worker percent joint rally. You may be remembering that after that, the government announced an increase for the Anganwadi workers and ASHA workers. There, the Anganwadi workers now are getting from 2018 September onwards 4,500 rupees per month for the worker and 2,250 rupees for the helper. Piece rate workers. So the regular health sector work was totally put on hold. So their income from those works, that piece rate of each, the other sector, the immunization service, those things, there was no income. So the basic from the central government, these 2,000 rupees announced, this rupees, that was the only income they were supposed to get. That also they were not getting. So in this context, they were taking this demand all over India, and we have observed means asking for safety various days, but we never stopped work. So there in Haryana, after 4 months without the safety, they were working, and they were forced to go for a struggle. They started the struggle it's now, I think, more than 70, 75 days. So they started the struggle. It was not the strike, but it was the struggles. They had demonstration, they gave memorandum, all those things. So after a point, they were even refused to speak. The ministers or the officials had some round of negotiation or discussions, but there was no decision at all, because the payment part was to be taken as a political decision. The ministers refused to talk to them. So there the strike started, and then in the strike also they were having demonstrations, and they had a big demonstration in front of the health minister's residence, where now people are working from their residence. There they had a very big rally, and the health minister refused to meet them. And then again they were going to the chief minister's residence. There, the day of their struggle, the chief minister was tested positive of COVID, and then OSD, he met the workers, the leaders, and he assured that anyway he can't meet you because he is in quarantine. So after, till that time, we will be working on that. So you please withdraw your strike, and then means we will be doing positively. I am assuring you on behalf of the CM, and for a meeting also. So this, then they withdrew the strike, but they continued the protest because nothing, none of their demands were met. Then again, after CM took, means came back on duty, they were not giving any appointment. Again, they had to go and for a demonstration, and then again, they were given a date for the meeting. And on that meeting date, the delegation went to meet the CM, and it was unilaterally cancelled. And then the workers were there, and the workers were they were demanding that you have already assured us for a meeting, you are not meeting us. So then they were brutally lathi charged. Labor codes, the working hours have been, as you all know, that the working hours, there is no more limit for 8-hour work. That has been done away with. And there is no kind of concept of minimum wage, which is the minimum wage concept is there in the codes, but it is not applicable to any of the, means 90% of the workers are out of the purview of whatever they have announced that minimum wage, which will amount to any something like 4,500 rupees a month or so. And the right of forming union, that is almost impossible. And right to go for a strike is totally impossible now. So I'm not going into the details, but the entire propaganda by the government is that all category of workers now we have included, which is a lie. And first of all, it is not at all. None of the labs in there, any of the definition, the scheme workers are coming under the definition of a worker. So the in the none of, and they are telling that we are including all category of workers in the social security. Even in the social security code, the Anwadi workers or the ASHA workers or any other scheme workers like the midday meal workers, they are not included in that. And there is no provision for getting social security also. And in addition, because they are not under the category of workers, the right to form association, now we are all registered under Trade Union Act. In future, the Anganwadi workers and ASHA workers will be refused to get the recognition even for a collective bargain. Status of the women, means the women's work, the entire care work, it is never calculated in any of these countries. this unpaid care work and the social status of women and the women's work, which is supposedly very divine, and this has to be it is free. So that social status is being utilized in these government schemes to press exploitation. So that is one thing, that whether the government was forced to introduce any kind of a social security scheme, which in this neoliberal period somewhere means instead of making a permanent arrangement for the health and nutrition services, they are introducing these schemes which they were forced to because of the people's demands and the struggles. But now they want to utilize this also to siphon off the money. This is not directly closing down or privatization. So the corporates are involved in this. In the nutrition component also corporates are involved. And then the corporate, in the name of the corporate social responsibility. Now you can see even in the new education policy, this PPP now not public-private partnership, it is private philanthropic partnership. So through that, the corporate and the corporate NGOs and the bureaucratic political nexus, they will be taking in charge of the entire people's money through the budgetary allocation process. So this is happening, and there is no role of the workers and their component in that. But what we are confident about the scheme workers' struggle, it is to be noted, all through this neoliberal era, this is one sector of workers which were continuously and consistently on the struggles, and they could achieve, they could negotiate with the governments, force the governments to give, means they were to increase their remuneration or other social security. And in addition to that, these struggles, it is not only having a direct implication on their own working condition, but it has given tremendous confidence to the other sector of workers also, and also even the peasantry. So the entire country is witnessing, and this is women, means 99% of the women, Anganwadi and Asha, totally women. So their struggles has given the confidence to the entire working class movement and the people's movement also. So that kind of a action is there and is continuing. And now with this 26th November strike and the other struggles of the peasantry is coming up. So there also these struggles are having a very big role in the future also, because these are the community health workers, community workers. So they are working among the peasantry also. So in addition to taking up their own demand, going to the people, means even trying to organize them, which we are trying from our own trade union, from the CATU, our federation. So there is an upsurge even in the areas against these government policies.